So, I want to talk about identity management. I'm going to take a little bit of a business perspective here. And I know most likely identity management is not your favorite conversation topic during a party. Most people find it kind of boring. And as a matter of fact, some of my colleagues and also one or two of my friends have warned me against it, saying things like, "Hans, you are a seasoned enterprise architect. Don't go there. This will ruin your career. This is a no-win proposition." Well, you probably know the drill. Maybe you've been there yourself. But I beg to differ, because my view is that identity management can be exciting. I've put up a little agenda. First, I'm going to talk about market dynamics. That's different from identity management. Then I'll try to explain how identity management fits in and the lessons we've learned during a large, big implementation we did. Now, look at this. As an IT industry, we haven't been shy about making big and bold predictions. Revolutions, transitions, taking things apart. Well, and most likely, if you're anything like me, at least, this is not your favorite kind of brain food. Or is it? Well, maybe a cover like this might succeed in attracting your attention. Who said identity management isn't sexy? But don't worry, I'll keep it safe for work today. When you look at all those stories, one thing springs to mind. No matter what, when they're talking about a connected enterprise or a digital enterprise or an extended enterprise, part of the disruption is that those new economic models are different ways to collaborate, splitting up companies, enterprises, and different ways of working together with parties in, so to say, a value chain. And this value chain, traditionally we think of it as something that flows from a producer to a consumer. And the modern thinking is more that it is an intricate web of parties working together and authorities, and sometimes a consumer is also a producer and things like that. Now, the project I did was in this industry. And this is an industry that may come to mind when you think about disruption. Business models are, being reinvented here, actually. I've been fortunate enough to do an identity server implementation for one of the larger European power utilities. And that implementation included 10 million of their customers, both individuals as businesses. That's why I said it's a rather large-scale implementation. Now, of course, you're aware that this business is transitioning from fossil fuel to low carbon. And this is having a big impact. I've prepared a couple of slides to basically illustrate how this impacts the value stream. Now, the traditional value stream, that's simple. Back in the days when life was still simple, at least we thought life was still simple. Generation of power, transmission of power, distribution of power. Well, what can be difficult about that? From an IT perspective, on the left side of the arrow, you do some value chain management. On the right side of your part of the arrow, you do some customer relationship management. Everything is fine and you're done. This has become a lot more dynamic. Look, for instance, at this one. Where has the value stream gone? It's completely blown to bits, to use one of the terms of those kinds of books. And one of the things that's happening in this industry is that what was traditionally called a consumer is not a simple consumer anymore. And no matter if it's an individual with some solar panels on his roof, maybe to charge his car, or it's, for instance, a farmer doing it on a larger scale, they're part of the day producing energy, part of the day consuming energy. They are prosumers. And all these kinds of technological developments, I'm not going into details because I don't have the time for that, that also opens up opportunities for new parties to enter this market. Not only to install the solar panels, but for instance with wind turbines you have a lot of maintenance. And well, a little bit later I'll show you that you can do even more. Well, actually, I'm going to show it now. Because what happens when you add storage into the picture? Energy storage, power storage, these. Nigel, in the keynote, in his keynote, already talked a little bit about it. One thing you can do... Is this not? Things that are being done here is what's called in the business peak shaving. Like I said, Nigel was already talking about peak use of energy, and peak usage is expensive. So in the industry, they are trying to invent new cost models to promote consumers to store their energy only when there is a peak supply of energy and use energy. To store it when there is a peak supply and use their own energy when there is a peak demand. And if you have intelligent, dynamic price models like that, you can promote economic behavior. But of course, managing those batteries, especially when you're a big, larger player, predicting based on weather patterns or on price predictions, what is the right time to charge your batteries and what's the right time to deliver the energy to the network? Well, that's a whole new kind of business. And new parties are entering into the market who develop software and strategies to optimize your own policies. Again, new parties entering the market. My last example for now is about sharing. And that's a couple of examples. There are many, many, many more to be found, where traditional consumers collaborate, cooperate, and start funding initiatives like this, collectively buying their own wind turbines, collectively sharing a roof in an apartment building, for instance. And again, well, you could say the value stream now is not from left to right anymore, but it is streaming around. Because those consumers, collectively, are producers. And they, the distribution company, buys the energy from their own consumers. Well, that's interesting. And when you look at this, from an IT perspective, customer engagement. Those new entries into the market, they understand how important customer engagement is. Traditional companies sometimes struggle to understand that. So, how identity management fits in? Well, you won't be amazed that in the end, no matter how futuristic the value stream is, at the end of the day, the money has to stream as well. And the more complicated your value stream is, the more complicated it becomes to identify the parties who are collaborating, who are trading, and applying the right prices but based on the right contracts. So that is why we need a reliable identification mechanism. Now, traditionally, companies, I already told that, are using big CRM systems to be able to charge random, right amount of money to the right parties. And with the developments in the value app in the market, basically, this is increasingly becoming a challenge. And the connected enterprise, and especially the dynamics in the market, make it challenging to do this right. So what did we do? First, and I don't believe that has been there. Somebody has talked about it already. What we did set up for all those prosumers, for all those businesses, is what's called a tenancy. Every company has its own tenancy. A customer has its own tenancy. And this tenancy enables the customer to basically manage their own user accounts. So as a utility company, the only thing I do is I create a tenancy for my business customer, and they basically do the rest. That's self-service. And that's, of course, attractive, to a certain extent at least. Now, those third parties, those service companies, how are we going to manage these? Well, like every employee of any business, an account gets created for each party an enterprise is doing business with. And maybe for each employee of that party. Frankly, from the utility perspective, I don't really care. But of course, this information is commercially very relevant. Who is doing business with whom? And perhaps I have a subsidiary who is competing with those parties. Now it starts to become interesting. We tried to solve this problem, and we solved it from maybe a surprising perspective. This third party, he perhaps is not happy that he has all those different accounts with all those different parties he's working for. Those parties are my customers. Now, what we came up with is a mechanism that's also not being talked about a lot. It is available in Identity Server, and it's called association. Association of different user accounts. And what we did come up with is providing those third parties with their own account. We call it a service account. And enabling them to associate their service account with all those accounts with those customers we have. And after the association, which is just a one-time process, they can switch and work for the company they want to work for. And the companies are still able to manage their accounts. So this is a win-win situation that makes life easier for everybody. That's legally correct. And we can harvest some pretty interesting marketing information from it. Okay. Does it make sense, by the way? Well, and I forgot to tell that. The beauty of the solution also is that those relationships are managed by the parties themselves, which keeps them pretty accurate, reliable. And it's not only that I don't have to do any work for it, I also have better, higher quality information. Okay. Identity server. You've probably seen this picture. And it's just to communicate that this is a pretty sophisticated identification platform, part of an even larger platform. We as a company, Cyber, are pretty heavily invested in this platform because it allows us to design architectures that fit to a problem a customer encounters. And we think that's always better than somehow simplify the problem in a way that it fits into your existing architecture. We try to embrace complexity. We don't want to exaggerate, of course. We don't want to make things more complex than necessary. But when complexities arise, you need clever architectures to be able to tackle those problems. And when you are starting to use a powerful piece of technology like this, you probably don't want to rip and replace existing systems. You want to rethink what is the possibility with this technology and how does it fit in. So you can call me old-fashioned, but when you talk about lessons learned, I still am of the opinion that having a good strategic dialogue at the beginning of the project, understanding each other, articulating a shared vision, it's the fundamental success factor for your project. Cloud computing. Cloud is built as one of those technologies that make building a connected enterprise easier, and it probably is. And one of the principles we agreed in the strategic dialogue was that this particular customer wanted to leverage their cloud-first strategy. So we did a cloud implementation. Now, what we often see in the cloud is that, I'm not having much time to talk about that, but that we still have siloed applications, and siloed applications are targeted at specific groups of customers. Now, if you have fully understood the dynamics in the value web, the traditional picture of a customer basically isn't there anymore. A customer, in other words, has his own value web to tackle. And if you want to do that correctly, you have to somehow break down those silos. And when you break something down, you have to put it together again. So identity management can play a role there as a matter of a trusted environment to share identities throughout all the components that are relevant in the value web, or however you want to call it, of a particular consumer. What we learned here, being successful is in the cloud, you want to have an architectural discussion with the customer. This was their first big cloud implementation. So we articulated an architecture, we designed an architecture in a formal language, Archimate in our case. And this architecture really helped to make architectural decisions. But we did have to do 9 iterations to come to the end goal. Well, how did it look? It was on Azure. This is how we started. I'm not going to talk about details. Sorry for that. You can talk to me later if you want to. But this is all the pieces we had to put in to make Identity Server work in a secure way in this cloud environment. Hybrid cloud environment, the platform as a service, infrastructure as a service, connections between it. So that, not only it looks complicated, but probably I also got some gray hairs from that. So, that being said, commercial transactions in a complicated web of enterprises is a challenge. It's a challenge, the kind of challenge I like. I hope you agree with me that identity management can have real business value And for you as a technologist, can also be an exciting area to work for.